Hi students, coming to the next topic in the subject microprocessor unit is 8251 USART. USART is a universal, U means universal, synchronous, asynchronous, receiver and transmitter. Means the data is transmitting and receiving in synchronous or asynchronous way. So this 8251 we call it as a universal, synchronous, asynchronous, receiver, transmitter. So actually this USART transmits only the serial data communication. It's mainly concentrated on serial data communication. So whatever the serial data that we are taking from the external devices, that will be transmitted to the microprocessor. So microprocessor internally it will be converted into parallel. So whatever the data that is sent by the CPU, that has to be converted into serial. Only the USART will take the serial data communication, because we can the external devices, that the peripheral devices, those input and output devices will take only the serial data information. So internally whatever it may be converted, but externally the data that should be in serial. So universal, synchronous, asynchronous, receiver, transmitter, USART is a serial data communication. This interface is packaged in 28 pin deep. So dual in package, so the pins that consisting of 8251 is a 28 pin. So this is a 28 pin chip. This chip is connected to the 8086 microprocessor to transmit the data, and it receives the data in a serial form. Okay, so that data should be transmitted synchronously or asynchronously. So here the receives parallel data from CPU. Let me write that point. Receives this USART receives the parallel data from CPU and transmits serial data after conversion. So first the first 8251 will receives this receives parallel data from CPU. A parallel data is received from CPU, and that will be stored in 8251. So the 8251 transmits the serial data. It transmits the serial data after conversion to external devices or to peripherals. Okay, at the same way, and also it receives serial data from outside and transmits parallel data to CPU after conversion. So it's acting as an intermediate device. So whatever the CPU is sending, the CPU always sends the parallel data, a parallel data to 8251. The 8251 will convert that parallel into serial and sends to the outside devices. Outside devices. In the same way, this 8251 will receives the, it receives the serial data from the outside and transmits to and transmitted to parallel data through the CPU. The CPU will take only the parallel data. So this 8251 will useful to convert parallel to serial and serial to parallel. Okay, now let us see the pin diagram of 8251. So I said this is a 28 pin dip dual in package. So this is the universal, synchronous, asynchronous, receiver, transmitter, 8251, a pin diagram. Totally it consisting of 28 pins, 1 to 14 one side and remaining 15 to 28 in another side. So here, let us see each pin one by one. Here you can see this, where is D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. So this is an 8-bit data bus. An 8-bit data bus used to read or write status or command words or data from or 2 to 8251. Means it's just, this is a 8251, so this is a chip. It transmits or receives the data. So 8-bit data from CPU or to from 8251. 8251 to CPU and CPU to 8251. So this D0 to D7. So it reads the data or writes the data. And next coming to C by D bar. C by D bar is nothing but it is a control word or data word. So C means control word, D means data word. So this is an input pin together read and write. Together read and write inputs informs the 8251 that the word on the data bus is either a data or a control word or status information. Means this control word or data word is indicating to the 8251 that the data bus is handling is getting the data, either it is a data or a control word or a status information. Suppose this pin is 1. Suppose this C by D bar is 1. It indicating control or status is on bus. Okay. So whether suppose it this C by D bar is 0, it means data is on bus. Whenever the C by D bar is 1, the control, the C is active and this is will be inactive. So the control or status information is on bus. Whenever this is 0, C 0 and D bar 0 means 1, data is on bus. Okay, so this is about the C by D bar. And coming to the next, you know the read and write signals. So read is to read whenever this the RD bar is low, 8251 is used to inform it that the CPU is reading either data or status information. So the CPU is reading either data or status information. Write means the CPU is writing. Always the CPU will write the data to 8251. So which is a parallel data is write to 8251. And the next pin is, let us see the clock. So clock is nothing but it is used to generate the internal devices timings and is normally connected to clock generator output. So it's just generating the internal device timings. So when to send the read and when to send the write and when to say place the data on data bus like that. So here the input frequency should be at least 30 times greater than the receiver or transmitter data bit transfer rate. And next coming to the reset pin. Reset means it's just resetting everything. So whenever this pin is active, 8251 is going to idle state. Means everything whatever that is present in 8251 is reset. Whenever the data is reset, it goes to the idle. So this device remains idle till this input signal goes low. Whenever it until it goes low, this device remains idle. So whenever it low, a new set of control word is returning into it. So after resetting, a new set of control word is written into it. Next coming to TXD, it's nothing but transmit data output. So it has to the CPU sends some information to 8251. So it transmits the data. TXD is transmitting the data output. So which is a serial data. So transmitting data means a serial data, already converted data, parallel to serial. 8251 converts the parallel data to serial and the data will be transmitted to the output devices, that is external devices. So along with the information like start bit, stop bit, parity bit, etc. Means the data that is transmitted in the form of start, stop and parity bit. And next RxC. RxC means receive data input. Receive is always input and transmit is always output. Receive data input. So this, sorry, TXC means receive clock input, not data. C, right. C means clock. Receive clock input. This receive clock input pin controls the rate at which the character is to be received. So when the whenever the character is received, that it controls the rate at which the character is to be received. In the same RxD, where is this RxD? Yeah, this is the receive data input. We call this is as receive data input. Okay, so this receive data input pane saying that 8251 receives a composite stream of data to be received by 8251, means a serial data, a composite stream of serial data has to be received. That will be indicated by this RxD pane. Next, RxRDY, that is a receiver ready. This is an output pin. Receiver ready output pin. This indicates that the 8251 contains a character to be read by CPU, means some information is there. This 8251 is having some information that is received, already received some characters. That characters has to be read by CPU. This receiver ready is sending some data to the CPU by saying that the character is ready. Character is ready. Okay, so in the transmit ready, so the transmit ready signal is an output signal. So this is also an output signal. So from 8251 to output, and this is an output to the CPU output. And this output signal indicates to the CPU that the internal circuit of transmitter is ready to accept a new character of transmission from the CPU. So already a character is there that is received from the CPU, and that character should be transmits ready to accept a new character for transmission from the CPU. So that is about the transmitter ready. Next, DSR. DSR is nothing but data set ready. So data set ready means this is normally used to check if data is ready when communication is in a modem. And DTR. DTR is data terminal ready. So whether the terminal is ready or not, that will be indicated by DTR. And RTS means request to send. Request to send data. So this signal is used to communicate with the modem. Request to send. And next, transmitter empty. So this transmitter empty signal can be used to indicate the end of transmission mode. End of transmission mode. So these are the different pins that are present in 82 connected to 8251. So each having their own operation. So this is a for 28 pin dual in package. So that is about the pin diagram of 8251 USA RT. Thank you.